what's it like being a filmmaker right now?
At the moment, the film industry, I feel, in the last year or so, is really changing. And it's an exciting time to be sort of an emerging filmmaker, because myself personally, I've grown up with digital technology, and I've had a few occasions where I've been able to shoot on film, 16mm film, which is sort of an older, which has always been like 35mm film has been the sort of the, you know, the level of what you want to shoot at, and it's the Hollywood look. And now in the last year, there's a new the new cameras that have come in, and the DSLR, so the photo cameras, and they've got the ability to shoot video on them. And from those cameras, people have been able to get sort of cinematic look from it, and they've been able to achieve that 35mm look on a camera that costs anywhere from like $1,500 to $5,000. And that's been a big game changer. It's put the sort of the tools that were inaccessible in places like Christchurch here, it's put those sort of tools in the hands of young filmmakers, and it's just given people an opportunity to shoot something that it really is high end. If you know, you still need to have the skills apart from the camera. You know, you've got to know how to light, how to direct actors, how to use camera movement and so forth, but it brings it down so that anyone can shoot something that is amazing now.
So you were the only crewman on for this film. What was that like?
I've been pretty used to it. Like, I shoot a lot of stuff with other people, and often I'll be the only crew member. Recently, in the last year, we've started building up crew and had some decent crews on. So it's been a while since I've crewed it by myself. But in some ways, it's a lot faster to shoot, because you can, if you've got an idea for a shot, you don't need to communicate to five other people on the set that you're gonna go do this. You just go do it. You just pick up the camera, go around, do it. So it can be a fast way to shoot.
Now the 48-hour film competition, the finals are next week.
Yep.
How do you hope Guerrilla Team Guerrilla's Death in the West is going to go?
I don't know. I don't know how we'll do it nationally, because I haven't had a chance to see Wellington or Hamilton, Taranaki, all the other films. I think just to make it in the finals, privilege, and because there were a lot of teams in Christchurch this year were really, really good, and so it was quite humbling to be given the top honour. And I hope we can represent Christchurch well on the main stage, and I hope it sort of stands up there as good as anything else in the country.
Because you won the sexiest film and the best cinematography as mm-hmm. well, so you're going for those things at the final as well.
Yes, yeah, we're up for best cinematography and sexiest short, and I think personally the cinematography would be the one that I would take most satisfaction out of, just because I have worked hard on my cinematography skills, and particularly on framing and camera movement. And the motivation of the camera movement, it's something I've started to sort of work on a lot in the last year or so. So to see it come out well in a film, and to work and to make the film better, was pretty satisfying. So it'd be good if the judges enjoyed it, if that makes any sense.
It does make sense. Yeah. Well, good luck. Next Thursday night are the finals.
Yes.
So good luck for that. Logan McMillan, thank you.
Thank you, Kaneda Knight.